Greetings, family. This is Bomani Tamba live in the flesh. And family, we are on our first Africa for the African, South Africa journey of a lifetime. And this is November 2019 journey. And it's 13 of us, literally family, 13 strong. A little shorter group than we're used to, but this is our foundation group and nice energy from an incredible group of brothers and sisters. Most of the people have traveled with me on previous tours. Today's a day where we're doing, you know, it's that brutal history of from the Apartheid Museum to Nelson Mandela House to Hector Peterson Museum and Memorial. And the goal of today, as we wear our Africa for African shirt for strength and solidarity, is really just to get our brothers and sisters to understand that we must learn about these, learn about all of our history as far as the unfortunate things that have happened to our brothers and sisters, to where we as a people have lost control of our continent. So us going back to learn about our roots, culture, learn about that brutal history is what's putting us in a situation where we can organize ourselves more to think about the higher level of things, business investment, community development, and things like that. Because at the end of the day, you know, we're in a world of competition, and when you come to South Africa, you realize that, you know, you talk about a nation where other folks, you know, it's not like in Ghana where you just, you know, it's just Ghanaians and just, or just all black people. You talk about something a little bit different, and you know. So we're trying to like literally just give you a certain history, because South Africa is one of those countries where if you don't, you know, if you don't literally share with your brothers and sisters, yeah, and do certain things, yeah, most of us won't know. Because when you go into the museum, honestly, you can't record, you know.
Right.
Some of us have to do certain things and, you know, get some documentation. So our goal is just to have these conversations, open your minds, but there's other things that you're going to see more documented. We did our best to show you what we can show you on previous other footage, but that's as good as we can get. But what I want everyone to do is open your minds up as you check out the different footages that we share with you on our wonderful experience, and think about traveling with us next year, November 2020. The website is, you see, africaforafricans.org, and we're organizing it. Right now we're just taking all kind of evaluation as our foundation trip times and looking at things, and we're going to perfect the itinerary and perfect your experience. And that's it. So, my brother, let me know if you have anything you want to ask me or for me to share.
No, brother. It's just, yeah. Just what is your experience? What did you get from the museum?
What I got from the museum basically is the white system is still pushing multiculturalism to the highest level. And one thing we have to realize when we see any nice museum or fancy exhibition, we have to always think about who invested in that operation, who put the money down and who laid it out. So when you go in there, clearly you'll see it's a situation where, you know, you already know that there's a lot of white people gonna be coming to the presentation. So it's kind of, they set it up to where it makes them feel like they're part of a future change and things like that. Everyone really have to get their own experience. But the Nelson Mandela side literally just went into overkill on us, the history. So, and then apartheid, I mean, from the big vehicles, which is one of the things that just messed me up mentally, because I remember seeing the footage where you have these big vehicles in Soweto, and then, you know, you have the white, you know, white Afrikaner police, and they got their guns through the little holes and mowing people down. I mean, this is not just like something that happened 500, 600, 700 years ago. We're talking about a few decades ago. Yeah, so, you know, it's you can spend a good amount of time, up to 3-4 hours, and read through everything. It's, you know, it's a good compilation of information. But the more conscious you are as a brother or sister, the better it will help you clarify certain things. Because one thing about these presentations, it reminds me of how we're miseducated in school, and especially when we're miseducated about our roots and culture. So consciously, you know, your oppressor will never just lay it out for you, you know, so you have to literally go look at the information and piece it together and put together a presentation and say, my brothers and sisters, let's put our resources together and let's make things happen for ourselves, because we realize that everyone else in the world is doing what they need to do for them and their people. And as much as anyone want to talk about Rainbow Nation and all this other stuff, we as black people, regardless in the southern part of Africa or South Africa, literally have to get that out of our mindset and think about what we need to do for ourselves. Because, you know, if someone is telling you, oh, we can all be people and we all one and all that stuff, but then they own everything, they own the infrastructure, they own the corporations and all the major aspects of what it takes to run a country. How is that equality, and how is that, you know? So it's one of those things that can confuse people, and then people feel like, oh wow, South Africa is open to all black people, all white people, all Asian people, all this different type of people, and they're making a nation where all people get along. And that's the biggest trick that our oppressor ever played on us, especially when we got fooled with the segregation situation, where we as a people, you know, was forced from segregation into integration, and then we realized that our oppressor have literally just benefited from that situation, because now instead of us being a community and organizing our resources and do what we need to do for each other, we're spending our resources with our oppressor. So it's the same situation when you're trying to build some kind of rainbow nation. If it's not going to be our black empowerment, then we're just going to be a victim of the system, and it's just modern day oppression. So family, don't want to get too deep into it, but
no, this
we're going to take you into more history. Hector Peterson Museum, Mandela House, which connects what you experience in the Apartheid Museum and the Nelson Mandela exhibit. So family, we're going to keep it black and keep it strong.